Now we've come to chapter 14, and the theme here is the Lamb on Mount Zion, the everlasting gospel preached in the world, and that Babylon will fall, and judgment and blessing is announced, and the coming of Armageddon also. So you see, this is a chapter that contains many things, and we'll be looking at that. Now, this chapter constitutes a hiatus in the series of the seven performers that concluded last time. Now, it's obvious that this interlude could not be fitted in between the sixth and seventh performers, who are the two wild beasts. First, the wild beast out of the sea, the wild beast then out of the earth. They had to be considered together. They're just like Siamese twins, and the continuity between them could not be broken. Therefore, this interlude follows the seventh performer in recognition of the logical sequence of this book, which is not a hodgepodge of visions, but it unfolds in a logical, chronological, and mathematical order. Now, there are certain performers here that are called to our attention in this chapter to give us a full-orbed view of the spectacular events of the two previous chapters. In other words, there are other performers besides the seven that are mentioned. And it's clear from chapter 13, and we mentioned it then, that that's the darkest day and the most horrible hour in history. It's truly hell's holiday. And every thoughtful mind must inevitably ask the question, he can't avoid it, how did God's people fare during this period? Could they make it through to the end with overwhelming odds against them? Well, the shepherd who began with 144,000 sheep is now identified with them as the Lamb. And do you know how many he has with him? Well, he doesn't have 143,999 sheep. He has 144,000 sheep. He did not lose one, for he redeemed them, and he sealed them, and he kept them, for he is the great shepherd of the sheep. And these sheep are of another flock that are not of this fold. That is the fold we're in today. He got these sheep through all right. And that's a picture that's before us now as we open this chapter. And he's going to have the last word, not the two beasts. The Lord Jesus will, the Lamb. And this is not the Lamb that speaks like a dragon. This is the Lord Jesus himself. And since he's going to have the last word, Babylon will fall. And that will be the great political capital, the great commercial capital, and the great religious capital of the world during the Great Tribulation. It'll fall, and the followers of the beast will be judged. Many of his own became martyrs, but they didn't lose. They won. Again, I say with Calvin, I'd rather be on the side that seems to be losing today, but it's going to win finally, than to be on the side that seems to be winning today, but it's going to lose eternally. I'm glad I'm on the winning side. Now, we are told them that they're martyrs and their works fall after them. He's going to reward them. And the Lamb's returning to the earth. We're going to see that when we get to the 19th chapter. And the morning is coming. The darkness will fade away. And the Son of Righteousness will arise with healing.